Harper Audio presents The Body Book, The Law of Hunger, The Science of Strength, and Other Ways to Love Your Amazing Body, by Cameron Diaz with Sandra Bark. Read for you by Cameron Diaz and Sandy Rustin. This is Cameron Diaz. Introduction. Knowledge is power. Hello, lady. Thank you for listening to this audiobook. Before we launch into chapter one and I let a professional narrator read you the rest of this book, I wanted to tell you why I wrote it, what it means to me, and what I hope it will mean to you. As human beings, when we have experiences that bring us great joy and fulfillment, all we want to do is share that excitement with others. Like when you eat something incredibly delicious and immediately you turn to the person next to you and say, "Taste this!" Or when you hear a really amazing song and then download it for a friend because you can't wait for her to hear. Or when you learn a piece of information that just really blows your mind, something that feels so big and important that you want to share it with everyone you can find. That's how I feel about this book. Everything I tell you is information that I use in my life. Information that makes me feel so excited and joyous that I just had to share it with you. That's why I've written it, because educating yourself about your body is one of the most important things that you can do. As you listen, you're going to learn about nutrition and how to feed yourself deliciously and nutritiously. You're going to learn about fitness and how your body is affected by movement. You're going to learn about your mind so that you can become self-aware and find your inner discipline. Because nutrition and fitness and awareness and discipline are not just words, they are tools. They are power. They are ways to care for yourself that empower you to be stronger, smarter, more confident, and truer to yourself. And the subtitle of this book are the words, "Your Amazing Body." I believe just that. Your body is amazing. Right now, whatever shape you're in, your body is an amazing machine that does so many cool things. From using the air in our environment to keep your brain alive, to turning a bowl of cereal into an explosion of energy that allows you to run down the street to catch the bus. And knowing how to take care of that body is the most important information you can ever learn. Ever. Because your amazing body is the only body that you will ever have. The same body you've had since you were a baby is the body you will inhabit when you are 75 years old. And along the way, yes, it has changed, and it will continue to change, but it is still yours. No matter what the shape is, how much you love or hate it, whether it feels tired and worn down or lively and invigorated, your body is the most precious thing you have. Your body is your past, present, and future. It carries the memory of your ancestors because you are made up of the genes given to you by your parents and their parents before them. It is the culmination of everything you have ever eaten, all the physical activities that you did or didn't do, all the efforts that you've made to understand and take care of it. And how well you care for it will determine how well you are able to live your life. So whether you wish you had longer legs or smaller hips, bigger boobs or less pointy ears, this book is for you. It's a guide to accepting what you have and loving it with everything you've got, to appreciating how incredible this physical vehicle is. It's a guide to maximizing your strength and endurance so that your body can take you everywhere you want to go in life, to all of your success, to the love of your life, to your passions and adventures. The body that you have is the body that will literally carry you there. So if you want to get to all those wonderful destinations, you have to build the strongest, most capable, most powerful body that you can. You must learn to live well in your uniquely beautiful body. But you can't do that if you don't know how. Unfortunately, as women, we are constantly being pressured about being more beautiful, about being thinner, about looking younger or sexier or blonder or more brunette. As women in today's society, we are encouraged to compare ourselves to other women, when what we need to do is focus on our own strengths, our own capabilities, our own beauty. That's why I wrote this book, so that together, we can learn the science behind the words and have the power that comes with knowing the truth about our bodies instead of absorbing the bias and misinformation that surround us. I'm not a scientist. I'm not a doctor. What I am is a woman who has spent the past 15 years learning about what my body is capable of, and it has been the most rewarding experience of my life. Everything that I have, everything that I am, relates to my knowledge about my body. And I want you to have that same thing. I want you to know yourself, your power. I want you to be the most powerful, capable, confident woman that you can be. I want you to know what it feels like to have a relationship with your body, to feel connected to it. I want you to know the true joy of living in a body that is yours and yours alone, of knowing how incredible it feels to nourish yourself with good food, to move and sweat, to truly care for your health. Because once you possess that knowledge and you are living in the body that you are meant to be living in, you will find that your energy is boundless and that you can see and experience the world in a way that you couldn't before. And you will start to be able to use your energy in ways that you never even thought of before because you were too focused on what you thought you didn't have or couldn't do. Because I want all of this for you, I spoke to people who are experts in medicine, nutrition, fitness, science, health, and psychology. People who have dedicated their lives and careers to understanding and helping the human body and mind be the best that it can be. It is their knowledge that I share with you, and it is my own journey of learning and taking care of my body that I offer to you as an example of how to apply that knowledge so that you can enjoy the benefits. When you have finished listening to this book, when you have integrated this information, when it is really inside of you, in your body, in your habits, you won't have to think about it anymore. It will become part of you. It will become you. When that happens, all of your energy is transformed into positive energy aimed at doing, accomplishing, being, creating things in the world instead of worrying about how you look, why you feel tired, why those pounds just hang on and slow you down. Just think of all of the amazing things that you could create in the world if you felt free, powerful, self-confident. But that transformation doesn't happen in a day, in a read, in a hope. The truth is that there is no such thing as a quick fix or a magic pill that will make you a healthy, happy human being overnight. To be healthy means that you must not only learn how your body works and what it needs to be healthy, but you must also apply that knowledge as consistently as you can towards making the best decisions that you can to achieve that health. It's an ongoing endeavor, not a one-time deal. That is why knowledge is so powerful. Because when you really know something inside out, you can see all the opportunities to apply that knowledge through action every single day. Here's what this book is not. It is not a diet book. It is not a workout regimen. It is not a manual to becoming a different person. Here is what it is. A guide to becoming yourself. Because as you begin to learn more and more about your body, something amazing starts to happen. You begin to transform on the inside and outside. You start to see how being healthy brings happiness into your life, how good it feels to be strong and able, how feeling good on the inside has an effect on everything else in your life. You will be the most beautiful and healthy and confident woman that you can be, and you deserve that because you are more beautiful than you have ever imagined. By the time you have finished listening to this book, you will be informed about how your body works on a basic level. You will be aware of how your mind and body work together. You will be more powerful because you will understand how amazing, how incredible, how beautiful your body already is, right now, right this very second. So what I'd love for you to do is to use this audiobook as a guide to understanding that amazing body and to help it to become what it has always been meant to be. Make this book your own. Take notes, ask questions, seek answers. and get ready to meet your true, powerful, healthy, confident, amazing self. One more thing. I want to let you know about the PDF that you can download with this program. It has graphs and charts and all sorts of information that we'll talk about in the audiobook and that you can refer to later. Be sure to download it. And now, I'm going to leave you for a little while and let you listen to this audiobook read by a professional narrator. I'll catch up with you in a few hours to wrap it up. Happy listening.
Part 1. Nutrition. Love your hunger. Chapter 1. You are what you eat. Once upon a time, you were so small that you weren't even visible to the human eye. You were just a cell in your mother's womb, a single microscopic speck. And then you became 2 cells, then 4 cells, then 8 cells, and those cells kept multiplying, copying, and differentiating until you became 100 trillion cells, each with a distinct purpose. Brain cells and skin cells, and heart cells and stomach cells and blood cells, cells that produce tears, and cells that produce milk, and cells that make you sweat, and cells that grow hair, and cells that help you see. The hand that is holding this book began with that tiny cluster of cells. Your entire body began as a barely perceptible dot, and somehow you grew into this amazing and glorious specimen. How does that happen? How did you develop from a tiny spot of life into this incredible, living, breathing, running, laughing being? How did your bones and muscles grow into what they are today? What about organs like your brain and your skin? Or the most important muscle in your body, your beating heart? What makes them continue to grow and function? And how do they come to be healthy or sick, strong or weak? There's one word that can answer all of these questions, and that word is nutrition. The nutrients in the food that you eat determine the way your cells develop, grow, and thrive, or not. When you were a bun in your mother's oven, your development was, at least partially, a result of her lifestyle and the nutrition that she put into her body. The other part was genetics, which she couldn't exactly control. And now, as a grown human made up of trillions of cells, your health depends on the nutrition you offer your body every time you eat. Excuse me, what's a cell? When I began writing this book, and I was getting all CSI about the body, that was one of the questions I asked. What is a cell exactly? One of the great things about that question is that humans have only known that cells exist for around 350 years. Before 1676, nobody had a clue about cells because nobody had ever seen them. Then a guy named Antoni van Leeuwenhoek peered at a slice of animal tissue through a stronger-than-ever-before microscope. And to his great surprise, he discovered that living things were actually composed of tiny little rooms, which he called cells. 3 centuries later, we know that the human cell is a complex living structure made of fat and protein, which are not, coincidentally, 2 key components of your nutrition. After you eat and your digestive system has its way with your food, your cells get to have a go. Your cells are basically miniature processing plants that use oxygen to convert nutrients from the food you eat into the energy that you use. Your cells are busy little bees. Some of them are the red blood cells that make you red-blooded. Some are osteoblasts, which are the cells that make up your bones. And all of your cells hold your genes in the form of DNA. That means that everything about you, from the color of your hair and your eyes, to your blood type, to your risk for developing certain diseases, lives in your cells, including your ovarian cells, which will create the egg cells that are a collection of your genes and can be passed down to the next generation. Your many different kinds of cells work together as a team to create your physical being. And whenever a member of the team can't function at its best, it's you who winds up in the doctor's office. Which is why you must act as a nutrition delivery system for your cells, finding and consuming the most nutrient-rich foods possible, so your cells can do everything they want to do, protect you, energize you, heal you, as well as enable you to keep thinking and breathing. Thank you, brain cells and lung cells. Because you are what you eat. You are what you eat. How old were you the first time you heard that saying? I've been hearing it since I was a little kid, but it wasn't until I was an adult that I really understood what it meant. When I was young, it just sounded like any other expression adults said, not like a piece of wisdom I could apply to my life. Back then, I didn't know how to connect the dots. I didn't know that the food I ate had anything to do with how I felt, let alone that it literally powered the cells that powered me. Today, I know better, and I know that this is what it means, that the food we consume over the course of a day creates the experiences we have in that day. Because what we eat carries the stuff of life, our lives. Your days may be full of energy and clear thoughts, happiness and gratitude.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.